Hello friends, let us solve another problem based on the Boussinesq theory. First, read the given problem. An elevated structure with a total load of 200 tons is supported on a tower of 3 legs. Okay. That means if you imagine a tower of any shape, it is having 3 legs. And whatever the load acting on the tower is 200 tons. The legs rest on a piers. Okay. This, what are the piers and all, we'll discuss in the deep foundation. As of now, let us imagine they are like a long columns. So these type of structures you will see in the rivers. So have you ever seen in the rivers with the power cables? They will be very long structures, but if you see at bottom, it will look like they will be either in the form of square shape or they will be in the form of triangular shape. The legs on a piers located at the sides of a triangle. So they are forming a triangular shape of each side 3 meter. Okay. The vertical stress due to loading at a point 2 meter below the any one leg is. That means if I represent a given data, how many legs are there? 3 legs, they are forming a triangular shape. Let us consider one leg, second leg, and third leg. Let us imagine that they are forming a triangular shape of each side. How much? 3 meters. Let us say this is the leg 1, leg 2, and leg 3. What is the total load acting on this? Total load is nothing but a 200 tons. So, what about the load on each leg? The total load is transforming through these 3 legs. So, what about the load on each leg? Load on, I will say each leg, or you can say each pair, the same. That will be equal to 200. How many legs are there? 3. So, that will be equal to, let us see if you solve this, 66.67 tons. Right, where you have to find, suppose if I draw the cross sectional view, so it will be like load on leg 2, load on leg 1, and load on leg 3. Where you have to find, we have to find at a depth of 2 meter below it. Let us say 2 meter. So here, how many loads are there? 3 loads. Because of sigma 1, let us imagine there is a stress. Let us represent with sigma z1. Because of load 3, sigma z3. Because of load 2, sigma z2. So, what about the total stress at that point? That will be because of 3 loads. See, 3 loads. Stress because of load 1, stress because of the leg 2, plus also stress because of the leg 3. Isn't it? Now, where we have to find? We have to find the stress at any one leg. You can find at this point, or you can find at this point, or you can find at this point. It's up to your wish. Let us say, I am finding stress at this point. Okay? So, if I am finding up this, okay, now, my load on leg 1 and my stress point is acting on the same line. So, if I am talking about the pier 1, let us say, what about my radial distance? That will be equal to 0. Why? Because the load and the stress acting point both are on the same line. Now, what about the radial distance for 3? And what about the radial distance for leg 2? What about the radial distance? If you see from top view, the radial distance between the point and the load acting point to the where you are finding the stress. Suppose if I see from top view, how it will look like? They will look like a triangular shape. Where I am finding the stress at 1. Where is my load acting? Q3 here. So what about the radial distance between these two? 3 meter. So if a load is acting at 3, if you are finding stress under the 1, what about the radial distance because of leg 3? That will be equal to 3 meter. Similarly, if my load is acting here, I am finding stress here. So what is the radial distance between these two? 3 meter. R2 is also 2 meter. Load is same, right? On each column, 66.67. Depth is also the same. So if I relate the equation Q divided by Z square, first let me write it down. What about sigma Z1? Sigma Z1, that will be equal to Q divided by Z square into 3 divided by 2 pi into 1 divided by 1 plus R by Z whole square whole to the power 5 by 2. Because of stress at 1, because of load at 1, as they are passing through the same point, radial distance will be equal to 0. So how will be your equation? Q 66.67, where you are finding the depth at a 2 meter into 3 divided by 2 pi. What about this term? Equal to 1. So that implies you will get stress under the load 1, that will be equal to 7.98 tons per meter square if you solve that equation. Now, if you see, what about stress at point because of leg 2? What about stress at point because of leg 3? For leg 2 and leg 3, radial distances are also same. We are finding at the same depth. This is same, this is same. And load acting on the both columns are same. That means the stress generated because of these two will be same. That will be equal to, simply I am directly writing this equation, 66.67. At what depth you are finding 2, that's why 2 square into 3 divided by 2 pi into 1 divided by 1 plus, what is the radial distance here? 3. 3 divided at what depth? 2. 3 divided by 2 whole square whole to the power 5 by 2. So if you solve this, you will get it around 0.42 tons per meter square. Now, what about the total stress under any one column? Sigma Z, that will be equal to sigma Z1 plus sigma Z2 plus sigma Z3. Sigma Z1, we are getting it around 7.98. Sigma Z1, sigma Z3, 0.42 plus 0.4. So the stress below the 3 meter under any one leg, that you will get it as around, if you solve that, you will get 8.8 tons per meter square. Only the thing you have to remember is that R is nothing but a, from top view, the radial distance between point where the load acting to the where you are finding stress. So in most of the cases, the mistake will happen in finding the R value only. Remaining all data in exam they will give you. So while finding the R value, make sure that you will look into the top view and you will take the radial distance. Okay. Thank you.